Dear learners, very good day to all. Today that we are going to learn about employee social security and welfare. Social security. So why it is necessary? What is the importance of it? The wages provided to the employees, particularly to the lower level employees, may not be sufficient to meet their regular needs like children's education, medical needs, maternity benefits, maternity needs there to their women employees. So therefore, governments of various countries insist the employers to provide security to their employees against the social evils. In addition, governments also provide social security measures to the people. So, what is the meaning of social security? According to Lord Beveridge, social security is an attack of five giants. So, those five giants are want, disease, ignorance, squalor, and idleness. So the concept is related to social justice and equality. Social security is designed to prevent and cure disease, to support when people are unable to earn and restore to gainful employment. So what is the need of this social security and welfare programs in an organization? So to satisfy the employee demands. So every employee will have, of course, the organizations are providing fringe benefits even though they will have some demands. Trade union demands. Employers' preference. And they will maintain it is as a social security measure. And organizations will look into the improvement of the human relations. That is why social security and welfare programs are very important. They are in need of that. So let us look into the objectives of social security. Why? What is the key objectives? What is the center point of the social security? So it is to create and improve the sound industrial relations, to maintain amicable relations between employee and employer, to boost the employee morale, to motivate the employees, to provide quality work environment and work life to the employees, to provide security to the employees against social risks retirement benefits, such a way, to protect the health of the employees by providing safety measures, to promote the employees' welfare. So these are the benefits social security was implemented. So here we can see some international standards of social security. Before that, we would know about what kind of legislative boundaries are there to secure this social security measures. So in India, we have five acts related to social security. So first one is Workmen's Compensation Act 1923, which enforces the employer to provide compensation to a workman for any personal injury caused by an accident for loss of earnings. The next one, the Employee State Insurance Act. So as per this act, employers has to provide sickness benefits, maternity benefits to women employees, disablement benefit, dependence benefits, funeral benefits and medical benefits. So this act will support the family and the employee too. So here next, the Employees Provident Fund and Miscellaneous Provisions Act. So according to this act, the employer has to provide provident fund, deposit linked insurance to the employee. The next, the Maternity Benefit Act 1961, which provides medical benefits and maternity leave to the employees. Next one, the Payment of Gratuity Act 1952, which provides for the payment of gratuity at the time of retirement. So here the gratuity is specially recognition for the employee for their long-term service in the organization. Then only they are eligible for that gratuity. So next one is the social security legislations at different countries. Let us look at how other countries are implementing the social security measures. So a comprehensive social security was originally introduced by Germany, which includes sickness insurance, accident insurance, old age, that means pension insurance, and unemployment insurance. So these benefits were provided through some laws in Germany, which is listed here, Wage Earners Sickness Insurance Act 1883, the Accident Insurance Act 1884, the Invalidity and Old Age Protection Act 1889. So this act comprehensively tells about the social security measures taken by Germany. In USA, that's we are predominantly looking to the higher country, that's how they are implementing the social security measures. So social security benefits include old age and survivors insurance, disablement benefits, hospital and health care benefits, layoff compensation. So by concentrating on these areas, USA typically has some laws. So here just listed some Occupational Safety and Health Act, Occupational Safety and Health Administration Act. These are the two leading acts which typically talks about the social security of the country, of the employees who are the citizens of the country. Such a way, we will talk about some UK. In UK, the social security benefits includes accident benefits, insurance against unemployment, sickness benefits, health benefits, housing benefits. In Japan, social security measures include in such a way medical care, health insurance, pension, old age survivors, and disablement insurance, unemployment insurance, etc. In this way, some different countries are concentrated on the specific area and they have some legalized framework for it to protect the interests of the employee, to protect the security of the employees. So now let us discuss about the fringe benefits. So what is fringe benefits? So fringe benefits are the extra advantages provided by the employer in addition to salaries and are considered important in terms of employee satisfaction, motivation, and long-term goodwill of the organization in the market. So here, typically fringe benefits are categorized into these five categories. First one is payment for time not worked. But the time not worked, really? Of course, we all know about that. So what are those categories? The first one is hours of work. So generally, according to the Factories Act 1948, in Section 51, they discussed, specifies that no adult worker shall be required to work in a factory for more than 48 hours in a week. 48 hours in sense, in a week is considered as 7 days, obviously. So Section 54 of the Act restricts the working hours to 9 in any day. So any day, if you could work for 9 hours, so according to that, the total number of 48 hours will be calculated. Likewise, the number of working hours has to be counted. So working hours, as of we know that 8 hours are the fixed working hours. So next one is paid holidays. So what is paid holiday? Are we getting paid for Sunday specifically? Because according to Factors Act 1948, an adult worker shall have a weekly paid holiday, preferably Sunday. So Sundays, When a worker is deprived of weekly holidays, he is eligible for compensatory holidays of the same number in the same month. For example, if an employee worked for one Sunday, so he is eligible to take that Sunday leave on any other day within that month. So some organizations are allowing the workers to have 2 days as paid holidays in a week. That means 5 days working. So next one, shift premium. So we are in the world of MNCs, multinational companies, and we are globalization has happened. So shift premium, shift. So companies operating second and third shifts. Many of the companies are working in the shift basis, first shift, second shift, third shift. So employers will get extra payment for those odd hour shifts. Odd hour shifts means usually people may work from 9 to 6, 9 to 7. So some people, if they are working for night shift in odd hours, they will get paid for those odd hour shift. That is called shift premium. Next one, holiday pay. So generally organizations offer double the normal rate of the salary to those workers who worked on paid holidays. If someone worked on Sundays, definitely they are eligible to get double payment for their work. That is holiday pay. Next one, paid vacation. Workers in manufacturing and mining, some related employees who worked for 240 days during a calendar year are eligible for paid vacation at the rate of 1 day for every 20 days. So for example, paid vacation in sense, who worked for in any year, 3 year calendar year in sense, it may be academic year, it may be financial year. If they worked for 240 days, they are eligible to get paid vacations. Like if you see academicians like us, so we do have usually 1 month paid vacation. Some government organizations are providing 2 months of the paid vacations because of this, because they are continuously working for some prescribed number of days. This is about payment for time not work. Employee security. Second one is employee security. So employee security. So physical and job security to the employee should also be provided with a view to promoting security to the employee and his family members. So the benefits of confirmation of the employee on the job create a sense of job security, definitely. So here we have two kinds of the compensation towards the employee security. Retrenchment compensation, layoff. What is retrenchment? First of all, we all know about the compensation. What is retrenchment? Retrenchment means discharge of surplus staff by the employer. So now we are in the period of COVID-19. We are looking into many people are throwing out of company. They are reducing the cost. They are reducing the employees. This is called retrenchment. So retrenchment compensation means, according to Industrial Dispute Act 1947, which provides for the payment of compensation in case of retrenchment and layoffs. So sometimes the non-seasonal industrial establishments who have 50 or more workers are employment, they have to give 1 month notice or 1 month wage to all the workers who are retrenched after 1 year's continuous service. So in the act, they discussed an employee who have completed 1 year of the service. He is in the list of the retrenchment. He has to be provided with 1 month prior notice. That means that you have to be retrenched. That means you have to leave the company. Either if he has to be provided with 1 month of the compensation. So this is called retrenchment compensation. As the layoff, we all know about it. This is the layoffs means closing of the company. So where we can say it as inability of the employer. Yeah, small change, it's an employer. Inability of employer to provide employment due to natural calamities like COVID, any earthquakes, floods, shortage of raw materials, accumulation of the stocks, breakdown of the machinery, and any other connected leave. Due to this reason, if employer are unable to provide the employment to the employees, then obviously they have to close the organization. That is called layoff. So then what is the condition of those employees? So in case of layoffs, employees are entitled to get layoff compensation. At what rate? At the rate of 50% of the total basic wage and dearness allowance. So we do have act for this. Actually, they are eligible to layoff compensation can normally be paid off 45 days in a year. So this is about employee security, safety and health. This is predominantly, we can see safety, health is precious. How far these organizations are protecting the health of the employee? How far they are providing the safety to the employee in the biggest industrial establishment when the employees are working in a chemical factory? So employee safety and health should be taken care in order to protect the employee against accidents, unhealthy working conditions, and to protect workers' capacity. So here, in according to Factories Act, they discuss this about stipulated certain requirements regarding working conditions with a view to provide a safe working environment. So these provisions relating to what they discussed about. So in Factories Act, they told about cleanliness, disposal of waste and effluents, ventilation and temperature to be maintained in the working environment, disposal, that's exhausting of the dust and fume, overcrowding, that's many people should not gather at a time, lighting, sufficient drinking water, public utilities. So this kind of the provisions has to be taken care by the employer to generate, to make the employee fit and good, feel good, healthy in the work environment. So provisions relating to safety measures including fencing of machinery. So someone, if they are working some moving machineries, they have to be protected with some kind of the measurements, communication boards, communication lines. So employment of end persons on dangerous machinery, they should not allow the end persons to work on dangerous machineries. So likewise, the company organization has to take care of, they have to prescribe many safety measures to the employees. Next, workmen's compensation. So safety and health, so that has to have some monetary benefits in terms of the safety and health. In addition to safety and health measures, provision for the payment of compensation has also been made under Workmen Compensation Act. So this act, what they told, is intended to meet the contingency of invalidity and death of a worker due to an employment injury or an occupational disease specified under this act. So this act covers the employees whose wages are less than 500 per month. Of course, typically they are the laborers, daily wage workers. So amount of compensation depends on the nature of injury and monthly wages. If something, even though safety provided, one person was injured, one person was partially disabled, it was lead to death. So according to the severity, the company has to provide some compensation to the employee and his family. And health benefits. Nowadays we can see that many of the organizations are providing Zoom facility to their employees at free of cost to encourage them, and yoga classes, some kind of recreational clubs to recreate, recreational kind of laughing clubs, and so some kind of the groups they are going. So here, medical facilities in sense, this health benefits, maintaining the gym facilities, and medical services like some they must have a room, they must have some, according to the number of the employees, they must have some dispensary facilities. Such a way, the organization has to provide some benefits to the employees and also to their families. According to the size of the industry, health benefits has to be provided to the employees. Some companies are providing gym, some companies are providing some doctor and nurse, so at 10-year-old visits to the organization. Such a way, they have to provide some health benefits to the employees. Let us see into the welfare facilities. So, welfare and recreational benefits, which includes canteens. This is all known. Many of you know about this facilities, canteens, providing canteens at lower rates of the items. So, 2 rupees, idli, 5 rupees, or sampar. Some companies like Nippo. Many companies, not only Nippo, some companies are providing canteen and consumer credit societies. So most of the large organizations located far from the towns and which provides housing facilities near to the organization set up the consumer stores to the employees in the employees colony and supply all necessary goods at fair prices. Consumer credit societies. So next to the consumer society, that is called consumer societies. Credit society is something different. The objectives of these societies are to encourage and provide loan facilities at reasonable terms and conditions, primarily to the employees. So they will be a member of the credit society. They will invest, they will save some money in that society. Whenever they want to use some amount, whenever they are in need of some amount, according to the saving, they will have benefit of the credit society. Housing, providing the quarters to the employees. Next, legal aid. So some organizations also provides assistance regarding legal matters to the employees whenever they need through the company lawyers and other lawyers too. So every company will have a lawyer associated with. So employees also can make use of those lawyers with some facilities. So next, employees counseling. So organizations provide counseling services to the employees regarding their personal problems. Professional counselors are available within the organizations whenever they are sick, mentally sick, whenever they are in stress, whenever they are in depression. These people will counsel the employees to reduce the absenteeism, to reduce the turnover, to target the good employees' health. Next, welfare organizations and welfare officers. So some large organizations, welfare officers, many large organizations will have welfare officers. So who set up welfare organization with a view to provide all types of welfare facilities at one center and appointed welfare officers to provide the welfare benefits continuously and this is very common welfare organization for the benefit of employees. Holiday homes. Some companies will maintain some resorts outside holiday homes and as a measure of staff and hand his or her welfare. In pursuance of government's policy, a few large organizations established holiday homes at a number of hill stations, health resorts, and other centers with lower charges of accommodation. So the employees can go there and they can avail that facility whenever they are going to visit those places. Educational facilities. So these educational facilities, that means the employee may go or their family will go, they will reimburse the fees. So setting, some organization will set up the schools where these employees' children will go and study. So providing grants and aid to the children, the employee and family. So these are called as educational facilities. Transportation to the employees. Recreational facilities. That means taking, giving parties taking the employees and his families to the picnics. So these kind of the benefits are called as welfare facilities. So finally, retirement. Till now that we discussed about the facilities provided to the employee during his work tenure. Now we are going to discuss about the retirement benefits after employment. After employment, obviously we all know that some companies are providing the pension. Some companies are providing provident fund. Okay, so the saving capacity of the employee is very low due to lower wages, usually. That's when we talk about the lower level employees. So high living costs and increasing aspirations of the employees and his family members, how he is going to cope up with after the employment. So these retirement benefits will support him after the employment. So what are these benefits? Provident fund, pension, deposit linked insurance, gratuity and medical benefit. Provident fund. So we have a law about this. So every company will give some amount of percentage deposit in the employees account. Pension in sense, so Government of India introduced this scheme, employees pension scheme. So what is the purpose of providing the family pension and life insurance benefits to the employees of various establishments or organizations? So why they are providing all these benefits, providing pension? The government or nations are providing pensions because to support the employees, they are contribution, employees are contributing something, and as well government is also contributing something. Finally, these people will get it as a pension regularly after their retirement. Deposit linked insurance. The employees deposit linked insurance schemes, it was introduced long back in nearly 1976. So under the scheme, if a member of employee provident fund dies while in service, his dependents will be paid an additional amount equal to the average balancing during the last 3 years in his. So this is deposit link insurance. For example, the amount, let me avoid the example here. So let me complete it already. Gratuity, finally, gratuity. Medical benefits already we discussed, gratuity. So gratuity, we have a legal issue here, payment of gratuity act. So what is gratuity? Gratuity is payable to all the employees who render a minimum continuous service of 5 years with the present employer. So this is the recognition for the employee for his long-term service with the organization. It is payable to the employee on his superannuation, maybe while he is leaving the company or while he is retiring. While he is leaving the company, he may retire or he may going to other company. So after completion of 5 years only, he is eligible to get this gratuity. So this is one benefit of retirement benefit. Finally, medical benefits. So some large organizations, they will provide some medical benefits to their retired employees also. They will have some association with some hospitals. In that prescribed hospitals, they will assist and assure the good service on behalf of the organization to the retired employees. So this is about employee fringe benefits. Thank you all. Wish you good luck.